Music Access.
In Korea, we sometimes see snowflakes in May. The beautiful white cherry blossoms flutter in the wind like snowflakes and fall to the ground. It's really beautiful. In May, many families go out on flower outings too. They put their faces among the pink, white, red, yellow flowers and say kimchi or cheese and take pictures. Then they blow it up and make it into a huge frame for their walls. They're probably trying to say, we're a beautiful family of flowers. That's the meaning of May in Korea. It's warm and it's like family, and you always miss it even if it's right in front of you. You guys, we're family too. Why don't we pretend we went on one of those flower outings? Let's take a family picture today. Everyone say, kimchi. No pulling your face back now. One, two, three. Kimchi. Hey guys, the first song we listened to together on Wednesday, May 1st, was All About You by McFly. And taking a picture with my Music Access family on the first day of May. It's a really good feeling. I feel like we're closer together as a family. The reason I say all of this is because in Korea, May is family month here. Is there anything special that goes on in May in your country? I would love to know. And guys, May 21st is my birthday. That is a national holiday, guys. Remember that. And here's how you can let me know, guys. Just click www.arirangradio.com and leave me a message on our Music Access message board. I'm always curious about the traditions and culture of where you live. Here's how you can listen. You can download the Arirang application on your smartphones or listen on your computers at www.arirangradio.com. And we've also got terrestrial DMB, or if you are on Jeju Island, through these FM stations. Jeju City is 88.7. Seogwipo City is 88.1. And the Daejeong area is 101.9. If you look at the very top of the message board, you'll see a list of people who will be receiving gifts from me. If your name is there, please email us your name and address at musicaccess@arirang.co.kr. Once again, guys, that's musicaccess@arirang.co.kr so we can send you your gifts. Remember to check every day. And before we get to the three times quiz and who in my corners, let's listen to two more songs. They are Fill Me In by Craig David and Thank You by Dido.
Next door when her parents went out, she phoned say, hey boy, come on right around. So I knocked at the door, he was standing with a bottle of red wine, ready to pour, dressed in long black satin, laced to the floor. So I went in and we sat down, started kissing, caressing, told me about jacuzzi, sounded interesting. So we jumped right in, all calls diverted to answer phone. Kinda cool, but they were the fine line between me and you. We were just doing things young people in love do. Parents trying to find out what we were up to. Saying, why were you creeping around late last night? Why did I see two shadows moving in your bedroom light? Now you're dressed in black, when I left you were dressed in white. Can you feel me? Clear, and she'd ask me to come out, I'd say, hey girl, come right around. So she knocked at the door, I was standing with the keys in my hand to the 4x4, jumped in my ride, checking and nobody saw. The club we went in, we got down, bound to the rhythm. So it was early morning, thought we better be leaving. So I gave you my jacket for you to hold. Told you to wear it cause you felt cold. I mean, I didn't mean to break the rules. I weren't trying to play mom and dad for fools. We were just doing things young people in love do. Parents trying to find out what we were up to. saying, why can't you keep your promises? No, won't say you'll be home by 12, from strolling in at 4. Out with the girls, but leaving with the boy next door. Can you feel me? Wearing a jacket, whose property? Said you've been queuing for a taxi, but you left all your money on the TV. Can you feel me? Two shadows moving in your bedroom light. Now you're dressed in black. When I left, you were dressed in white. Can you feel me?
Can you feel me?
Called my brother to answer phone. Red wine bottle, half the contents gone. Midnight return, jacuzzi turned on. Can you feel me?
Introducing our Music Access family members, Who Am I? What is Who Am I? It's a great corner for you, all of our Music Access listeners, to tell me more about yourselves. Tell me to get to know you better. Send me information about you. It can be your name, age, where you live, your nicknames, physical traits, what you think is fun about yourself, your records or feats, secrets, anything. Even if you sent us your intros and I already read them on air, don't worry. You can send them more on what you did that day, what you ate, if anything special happened, etc. on today's Who Am I. And don't just give up thinking that you've already been introduced. I want to know more about you and it'll really help me to remember you guys one by one. All you need to do is come visit us at www.arirangradio.com and leave me a message on our message board with the title, Who Am I? Now, let's listen to our first Who Am I? It is from Rochelle from the Philippines. Rochelle Zabala, 20 years old from Philippines. I don't have a lot of talents, like singing, dancing, etc. But one thing I love the most is to draw since I love anime. How about you, Arong? Do you watch or like anime? I've been a fan of K-pop since 2008. Because of my addiction to it and all things related to Korea, my classmates always scold me for playing K-pop songs or engaging in conversations using Hangul instead of our language. Because of that, I gained from them a nickname, Korean Girl, though I don't actually look like a Korean. What up, Rochelle Zabala from the Philippines? And you say you love to draw, so maybe if you're good at drawing, maybe pursue a career. I don't want to tell you to pursue a career in drawing, but you know, just I guess continue to pursue drawing. And anime, you know, I watch anime from time to time. You know, I'm not the biggest fan, but you know, I watch from time to time. And yeah, it's pretty crazy. You use Korean instead of your own language, which is, I think it's hilarious actually. And yes, thank you for your love and support, Rochelle. And let's go on to our next message, guys. Here's our next Who Am I, Tatiana from Puerto Rico. Hi, Aaron. My name is Tatiana, and I'm from Puerto Rico. Saying a little now about what's going on through my mind. I'm really nervous about my future. I'm entering 12th grade in the fall, a senior year, and I feel as time is passing by so fast, but I've yet to make a decision on what to study. It also doesn't help much when your parents have such a different perspective and want you to pursue different things. No matter what, I guess, I'll just try my best to find my place, despite how hard it seems to be at times. Thank you for reading. What up, Tatiana from Puerto Rico? You know, senior year is definitely stressful because that's the year before you go into college and, you know, everyone's like, oh, pick your major. But you know what? You don't have to pick your major now. You should go into college, you know, take your mandatory classes first. And from that, I guess you can find out what you like and then pursue a career in that field. So, yes, I wouldn't suggest making like a concrete decision on your career yet, because it'll definitely change in the future. Thank you very much. Here's our next Who Am I. It is from Manny from Hong Kong. I am Manny from Hong Kong, and I'm 14. I'm a love, and I really love New East, especially. Have you ever received a puzzle and some funny pics from HK, Hong Kong? Those are made by me and another fan. What do you feel about those gifts? Actually, I'm Maureen, and thanks for reading out my name on... I'm not sure what this does. I said it as my ringtone, KK, Maureen from Hong Kong. Fantastic. Please answer my questions and say something to me. Please, I'm sorry that I didn't listen to your radio yesterday because I have to go to school. What up, Manny from Hong Kong? Yes, we did receive your puzzle pics and stuff. I think it's hilarious and it's cute. You know, we put it up actually in our office, you know, for other people to see. So I want to thank you for your presence. And yes, Maureen from Hong Kong, I will give you a shout out. What up? Here's our next message, Jermex from Singapore. I guess this is going to be a big challenge trying to describe myself because it's going to be so awkward. To start things off, I am Jermaine, but my friends usually call me Jermex. I'm commonly known as a flailing bacteria or a happy virus derived from Jermex because I like to spread my randomness and laughter to those around me. That's it, I can be a little awkward.